You'd rather me to go down there? Okay. So I'm just love to have you open your hymn books with me as we begin our program this afternoon. Let's start by singing hymn number 312, Near the Cross. Jesus, keep me near the cross. 312. On verse 2. How about us, ladies?
Near the cross, a trembling soul, love and mercy found me. There the bright and morning star sheds its beams around me.
Join us, men. Just the gentleman on verse 3. All together on the chorus. Ready?
In the cross, be my glory ever, till my raptured soul shall find rest beyond the river.
All together, last verse. Page 308. Let's sing Holy Thine. We're in the consecration part of the hymnal. If you look at the bottom there, Holy Thine, 308. Let's sing that one together. All together.
I would be, dear Savior, wholly thine. Teach me how, teach me how. I would do thy will, O Lord, not mine. Help me now. Wholly thine, wholly thine, this is my vow. Wholly thine, O Lord, just now.
All together.
What I worldly pleasure, wealth, or fame, without thee, I will leave them all for thy dear name. This my wealth shall be. Wholly thine, wholly thine, this is my vow. Wholly thine.
As I cast earth's transient joys behind,
come thou near, in thy presence all in all I find, 'tis my comfort here. Wholly thine, this is my vow.
About 3:11, I would be like Jesus. Isn't that our prayer for us all, to be like Jesus? 3:11, I would be like Jesus.
Earthly pleasures vainly calling, I would be like Jesus.
Your turn, gentlemen. Let's have you sing the verse, second verse. All together.
Be like Jesus, this my song.
Just verse 3 for us, ladies.
All the way from earth to glory, I would be like Jesus, telling o'er and o'er the story. I would be like Jesus.
All together,
be like Jesus, this my song. Like Jesus all day long, I would be like Jesus.
All together, verse 4.
That in heaven he may meet me, I would be like Jesus. That his words well done may greet me, I would be like Jesus. Throng.
minutes for prayer. Father in heaven, that is our prayer, that we would be more like Jesus. We're here this afternoon, Father, to witness a baptism, someone who has decided, Jim has decided to follow you with his whole heart, and we're grateful for that, Lord. So we just pray that your Holy Spirit would be here with us, encourage us, and we pray all of this in Jesus' precious name, amen. So we will begin with the opening song.
Yes, my Jesus, I love thee. 321. Is that our prayer today? We can all stand for our opening song, 321, my Jesus, I love thee.
To welcome each one of you. Thank you for coming out on this special day. And thank you. Thank you all for coming. What I'd like to do at this time is we're going to keep singing hymns, but I'd like to open it up if there's any testimonies, not long testimonies, just 3 to 5 minutes or so, of what the Lord has done in your life or how the Lord brought you to Christ or how is it that you know about God. And so I'd like to open that up at this time. And so whoever would like to, I could come to you and you can do it right from your seat if you'd like to share. Is there anybody who would like to start off? Okay.
Back in November of 1984, I was sitting in front of the television watching George Vandeman on It Is Written, and his message that day came to my heart. I'd been born in an Adventist home, but I had not been born again. But the born again experience happened that morning. That's just a start. We're a baby at that time. and we're still growing.
Amen. Thank you, Brad, for sharing that. Beautiful.
I just wanted to say that in the third grade, my mother came back to the church, and I got to be in church school from then on. But when I was 9 years old, I really felt, because of Christian teachers and our Bible lessons and everything, I was baptized then. And when Alvin and I got married 36 years ago, we were baptized again together. And I felt like I needed a new start too. So praise God.
Amen. Amen. Isn't that amazing how the Lord leads each one of us in our lives? And is there somebody else? We'll sing a hymn after this one.
Well, I don't have a long story, but I was raised Lutheran, and then with my late husband, I didn't go to church, but I desired to be a Christian. I think I was watching television evangelism and all that, and I became born again in 84. And long journey, and moved up here, and I was widowed for many years, and went to church, and then I kind of got into work and school and a lot of working, and didn't really fall away, but was sort of away. And then I met Pastor Dronan. I started doing Bible studies with him, and course, the supper club, but I think the Bible studies introduced me, and a couple of years ago I became Seventh-day Adventist and came here. Praise God.
Amen. Amen. So which hymn will we be singing now? Nothing between. 322. Nothing between. That is what the Lord, He doesn't want anything between any of us. He seeks us, He finds us, He invites us. That's what we've heard from some of those testimonies. Be thinking. We'll ask again after this song if anybody would like to share some brief testimonies. We'd love to hear how the Lord has worked in your life. 322.
Nothing between my soul and the Savior, not of this world's delusive dream. I have renounced all sinful pleasure. Jesus is mine, there's nothing between, nothing between my soul and the Savior, so that His blessed face may be seen. Nothing preventing the least of His favor. Keep the way clear, there's nothing between. Nothing between worldly pleasures, habits of life, though harmless they seem, must not my heart from Him ever sever. He is my all, there's nothing between, nothing between so that His blessed face may be seen. Nothing preventing the least of His favor. Keep the way clear, let nothing between. Nothing nothing between in many hard trials. Though the whole world against me convene, watching with prayer and much self-denial, triumph at last with nothing between. Nothing between my soul and the Savior, so that His blessed face may be seen. Nothing preventing the least of His favor. Keep the way clear, let nothing be.
This song?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I was raised SDA, but I didn't stay with the church, and I drifted away, and for years, I thought I could go on my own way, and God just kept hammering on me, and He just wouldn't let me go, and even though I turned my back onto Him, and finally, I just couldn't take any more, so I had to stick with Him, and He made sure I came back. So.
Amen. Has it been a better life now?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so He didn't force you into it. He kept wanting to give you the very best. Amen. Any other? Yes.
I met this guy in 1980, and we started going to church, but I never really had any conviction. We got married, and we went to Georgia. He did reforestation work down there, and I met a lady named Kathy Sutton. And she started doing Bible studies with me. I still wasn't convinced. I was raised Catholic. Came back and I met Wilbur Woodham. Do you all know Wilbur? He was amazing. And he was a character. He'd play the handsaw. He was amazing. And he started having studies with me. And when our daughter was three, I got baptized. And Leroy got re-baptized with me that day.
Amen. It's amazing how the Lord unites us as families as well. Amen.
I'm 63 years old, so I've been working a long time, and I've never had trouble with getting Sabbath off. When I ask for a job, which is what usually any of us would do when we change jobs, you get permission from them, they agree, okay, you can have Sabbath off. I never had a problem with it. And people ask me this spring, a young Puerto Rican guy, how many of you work on Saturday? So I go to church on Saturday. We were supposed to go to church on Sunday. No, Saturday. Sunday, he says, and he... I didn't recognize the verse he used, but anyway, I said, well, it says in Genesis, 6 days, when God created the heaven and earth in 6 days, and the seventh day rested, sanctified it, and set apart. Oh, you read the Bible a lot? And I said, I've read it a few times. I have trouble with names, so that kind of gives me a problem. I pray for help with that, but I've always been able to get my Sabbath off. And so once we take a Sabbath off, one boss even said, your truck better be at church Saturday. You're working next week. I said, we'll be there, so.
Amen, amen. Any other? Are you raising your hand out? Yeah, okay, after this one, we'll sing another song, hymn.
Just a short one. Don't let the book, The Great Controversy, ever get a hold of you.
Got a hold of you, huh? That somebody, who handed it to you?
Ron Duman.
Okay, amen, amen. Okay, let's sing another hymn, one more hymn here.
How about number 306, Draw Me Nearer, 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 Blessed Lord, to Thy Precious Bleeding Side. 306, Draw Me Nearer.
I am thine, O Lord, I have heard thy voice, and it told thy love to me. But I in the arms of faith and be closer drawn to thee. Draw me near, 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 blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me near, 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 blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Consecrate me now to thy service, Lord, by the power of grace divine. May my soul look up with a steadfast hope, and my will be lost in thine. Draw me near, 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 blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me near, 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 blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Oh, the pure delight of a single hour that before thy throne I spend. When I kneel in prayer and with thee, my God, I commune as friend with friend. Draw me near, 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 blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me near, 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 blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side.
Any final testimonies here?
I had wandered off. I was raised as a Seventh-day Adventist, but I left when I got drafted. And when I came back home, I started college, and the Lord doesn't let you run away. And I was in this world history class, and I thought I was back in an evangelistic meeting because the guy was teaching about Luther, and I'm like, oh, I can't run away. Can't run away. So that I decided that it was time to come back home. Been here ever since.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. And the Lord keeps working with each one of us and continues to draw us near and near to Him. At this time, we will have a special Ralph and my wife. And then we'll have Jim share his testimony here.
Isn't that a beautiful song? I'd rather have Jesus than silver or gold. I'd rather have him than riches untold. I'd rather have Jesus than houses or land, or be led by his nail-pierced hand, than to be the king of a vast domain, or be held in sin's dread sway. I'd rather have Jesus than anything this world affords today. I'd rather have Jesus than silver or gold. I'd rather be his than have riches untold. I'd rather have Jesus than houses or lands. I'd rather be led by his nail-pierced hand
than to be the
This time we're going to have Jim come and share a short testimony of how the Lord has led him to the point of baptism at this time.
I'd rather have Jesus. Wow, that was a remarkable song. I know that we all think this. I'm just going to make one request before I start. I know that Ben turned off the air conditioner for me so I wouldn't get cold in there. But looking around, I see everybody sweating. So if you could turn it on, that'd be okay. Because I see everybody's using their fans and stuff, so so don't worry about me. I feel major humbled. So many people came out just for me. Jesus didn't even have a ceremony like this when he was baptized by John. So I feel major, major privileged. Just to tell you a little bit about me, since you're going to be accepting me in your church. I was born in a middle-class family down in Detroit. My mom had 5 boys, no girls, so yeah, she had a really hard time. We were in a Catholic neighborhood, so I was raised Catholic. I went to Catholic schools all the way up until they closed. After they closed, we went to public schools because we had to. I knew Jesus. I knew God my whole life. Did I know him like I do now? No. I thought I did, but it's a total different upbringing. The way that they teach and everything is so different than it is here. I graduated high school. After I graduated high school, if anyone remembers the 70s and early 80s, there used to be these TV commercials. Hey, join the Navy, travel the world. Remember those commercials? Well, I thought, yeah, why not? Free, you know? So I my whole family, my dad, my grandpa, everybody was Navy. So I wanted to go into the Navy, kind of. But since I was a kid, I was a little bit scared. So I thought, well, I'm not going to join the Navy. I'm going to join the Marine Corps. You know? So I joined the Marine Corps. I got home after I did that, and my dad was kind of mad at me because I didn't join the Navy. But the Marine Corps is a department of the Navy, so he's like, why did you join the Marine Corps? I said, how far can you run on a ship? You know, you know, I wasn't that dumb. You know, if a war starts or something, I want to be able to run away. You know, I don't want to sit there in the middle of the ocean waiting to drown. So I joined the Marine Corps. Was kind of a bad decision for me. Right after I got out of boot camp and went to school, right out of school, the very first thing they did was they sent me to Beirut, Lebanon. Soon as I got there, within a week or two, terrorists went there, drove a truck into the Marine barracks I was staying at, and killed like 238 Marines. So my baptism in the Marine Corps was digging out bodies of my fellow Marines, taking them to the care centers, the ones that were living, and burying the ones that weren't. From there, I thought that had to be the end. How could it get any worse? Well, all of a sudden, I'm on my way to Grenada. I'm on my way to Panama. I'm on my way to different conflicts all over. Again, I thought, how can that be any worse? How can it be worse than this? Well, in 1990, I'm on my way. I'm sitting in the Philippines. I've been in the Philippines for about 8 years. And all of a sudden, I'm on my way now to Saudi Arabia to go fight for Kuwait. While I was there, it got a lot worse, a lot worse than anything else I've seen. I was forsaking God, I really was. How could you let this happen? How could you let my fellow Marines get killed? I totally went against him. You know, how could he let this happen? I didn't know that he had a better plan. I didn't know, you know, what he had in store for me. I prayed every single day. There's not anybody who ever went there that would tell you that they don't pray every single day. We pray in the morning and then yell at him at night. That's just the way it is. I was lucky. I survived. I got to come home. A lot of my brothers didn't. Actually, truth, most of my brothers that I was with in my units did not come home. I always came home. God had a plan. He had a plan for me. He wanted something better for me. After I got out of the military, I started trucking. a lot of times when I was trucking, there was so many things that happened to me that I should not have walked away from, but I walked away from them. We know somebody from church here that got in a car accident, went off the road and smashed into a tree. Well, I fell asleep one day in my semi-truck. I got cruise control on. I'm doing about 80 miles an hour down the road. Next thing I know, I'm off the road going through the middle of the forest, you know, through the middle of the forest. I didn't hit one single tree. I didn't hit anything. I went straight through the middle where it was open. Both sides had all kinds of stuff that would have definitely killed me. I've seen so many other truckers when I was trucking that hit things, and I'm pretty sure that they didn't get to go home. But he protected me. He brung me straight through an area where he knew I wasn't gonna get hurt. The only thing that could have done that is Jesus, is Christ. So I am so thankful. I've always, like I said, believed in God. I've turned my back to him. My wife, Kim, she's always trying to get me to come to church, come to church, come to church. She went to several different churches, and I'd let her go to any church she wanted to go. I didn't go with her, of course. You all know that. but I let her go. I didn't want her, not to, believe in Jesus and get what, he gives. All I can say is in my heart that I am so grateful for you guys. I am so grateful for Pastor Henry and Christina. I was sitting at home one day and there was a phone call. And Pastor Henry and Christina calls up and talked to my wife and said, "Hey, would it be okay if I came over your guys' house and talked to you?" Kim, of course, is going to say yes because she loves talking to everyone. So they came over, and I sat down and I talked to them, and I just felt so welcome and so good that they did that they spent their time to come and try to tell me. They didn't push religion on me. They didn't do anything to make me feel uncomfortable. They just said, "Hey, if you want to come to church, just come. You don't have to stay or anything, just to see what it is." I said, okay, as everybody knows, because I came. The best part about it, though, is when I walked through those doors over there. I came through those doors not knowing any of you. But as soon as I walked through the doors, everybody greeted me. They all made me feel like this was my home. This is where I belong. You guys treated me better than my own family does. So I felt, this is where I gotta be. So this is where I am. I wanna thank the pastor. He spent so much time, way more time than any one person deserves. He would come to my house twice a week sometimes, once, twice a week, more twice a week than once a week. He told me one day, he said, "Normally a Bible study only lasts 1 hour." But I'm going to tell you that he was at my house sometimes 2-4 hours sometimes, because I just wanted to hear everything that he had to say. I wanted to learn everything there was to learn. I actually didn't want him to go home because, I needed so much information that, I was so grateful that this all happened. I want to thank you for allowing me to join your church. And God bless all of you.
You can stay here. Yes, it is best to do 45 minutes to an hour Bible study. The only reason why I did that is because don't do the other unless if the Lord leads. But only reason I did that because he was starving. Basically, he was starving for the Word of God, and He normally people would be tired of that, but anyway, the Lord led differently. One reason why we're doing it in the afternoon, he needs to be leaving actually, but let's pray. He has to go trucking for a while, But and he didn't want to, and I didn't want him to leave without being baptized, because he was ready. And you know, we want him to have the blessing of the Lord and leave a new man. But we don't want him to stay away, do we? So he's been trying to find a job here, so pray for that. And so he could be local. It'd be wonderful for him and his wife together here, and we would love to have him here at our church and work all of us working together. So at this time, I'd like to just go through the commitment of baptism, that the different studies and his commitment at this time, what he's committing to. He's joining Christ and his body and the local church here. And so my commitment in baptism, you can respond by saying amen or I do, is I believe that there is one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, a unity of three co-eternal persons.
I do.
I accept the death of Jesus Christ on Calvary as the atoning sacrifice for my sins, and believe that through faith in his shed blood, I am saved from sin and its penalty.
I do.
I renounce the world and its sinful ways, and have accepted Jesus Christ as my personal Savior, believing that God, for Christ's sake, has forgiven my sins and given me a new heart.
I do.
I accept by faith the righteousness of Christ, my intercessor in the heavenly sanctuary, and accept his promise of transforming grace and power to live a loving, Christ-centered life in my home and before the world.
I do.
I believe that the Bible is God's inspired word, the only rule of faith and practice for the Christian. I covenant to spend time regularly in prayer and Bible study.
I do.
I accept the Ten Commandments as a transcript of the character of Christ, of God, and a revelation of his will. It is my purpose, by the power of the indwelling Christ, to keep this law, including the fourth commandment, which requires the observance of the seventh day of the week as the Sabbath of the Lord and the memorial of creation.
I do.
I look forward to the soon coming of Jesus and the blessed hope whom this mortal shall put on immortality. As I prepare to meet the Lord, I will witness to his loving salvation and by life and word help others to be ready for his glorious appearing.
I do.
And I'd like to say something about that. God has moved, gotten a hold of his heart so much that, because it's saying here, help others to be ready for his glorious coming. After we would finish a Bible study, he would get on the internet and give his friends the same Bible study we just did. His friends from school. And how many are following you right now?
137.
He's doing these same Bible studies with 137 friends around Michigan and
they're all around the whole United States.
All over the U.S. So continue praying for those people as well. I accept the biblical teaching of spiritual gifts and believe that the gift of prophecy is one of the identifying marks of the remnant church.
I do.
I believe in church organization. It is my purpose to support the church by my tithes and offerings and by my personal effort and influence.
I do.
Amen. And he's not just saying these just to say them. He actually was already supporting our church and personal effort a long time ago. He says, I'll cut your grass for free. I want to help the church. He paints the lines. He's cut the grass and all these different things. The Lord has taken hold of his heart, and that's what I want God to do with me every day, more and more. Is that your desire too? I believe that my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit and will honor God by caring for it, avoiding the use of that which is harmful, abstaining from all unclean foods, from the use, manufacture, or sale of alcoholic beverages, the use, manufacture, or sale of tobacco in any of its forms for human consumption, and from the misuse of or trafficking in narcotics or other drugs.
I do.
I know and understand the fundamental Bible principles as taught by the Seventh-day Adventist Church. I purpose, by the grace of God, to fulfill his will by ordering my life in harmony with these principles.
I do.
I accept the New Testament teaching of baptism by immersion and desire to be so baptized as a public expression of faith in Christ and his forgiveness of my sins.
I do.
I accept and believe that the Seventh-day Adventist Church is a remnant church of Bible prophecy, and that people of every nation, race, and language are invited and accepted into its fellowship. I desire to be a member of this local congregation of the World Church.
I do.
Amen. So at this time, we will go back and prepare, and you can sing, I Surrender All.
Our hymn books to 309, I Surrender All. You can sing these verses as they prepare. 309, I Surrender All. All to Jesus, I surrender. All to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all. 309.
Surrender all.
some things that happened during the war that has burdened him and has brought a lot of guilt and burden on his life, his soul. And as we discussed baptism, he came to know the truth of the Bible, of Jesus Christ, that when we give our lives to Jesus, all that guilt, all the old self, dies. Amen. And he comes up a new man. So that's why we submerge. It represents death. And you come up a new life, a new person in God. So praise the Lord that Jim has accepted Jesus and desires to walk with him. And Colossians 3, 1 through 3 says that if then you're raised with Christ, Jim, and you're going to be raised up with Christ after this, seek those things which are above, where Christ is, sitting at the right hand of God. And Jim, you have to choose. It says, set your mind on things above. You have to make a daily choice to do that. You're going to be distracted. Satan's going to want you to fall away. He's going to put everything in your path. But you have to set your mind on things above and not on things of the earth. For you died. You're dying here. We have to die every day. For you died, and your life is hid with Christ. This is your life. It's hid with Christ in God. You're completely secure in God. So that, and I know you love Jesus and you want to follow him with your whole heart and you want to share it with everybody. So because of that reason, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Why don't we sing another hymn together as they come? How about we sing 319, Lord, I want to be a Christian in my heart, in my heart. Lord, I want to be a Christian in my heart. 319. Lord, I want to be a Christian in my heart, in my heart. 319. Lord, I want to be Number 330, take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Number 330.
To thee, take my hands and let them move.
about number 329, take the world, but give me Jesus. Oh, that's a good one. Take the world, but give me Jesus. Take the world, but give me Jesus. All its joys are but his name. But his love abideth ever through eternal years the same. Oh, the height, the depth of mercy. Oh, the length and breadth of love. Oh, the fullness of redemption. Cleansing Wave. We'll just sing the first verse of the Cleansing Wave, 332.
This time we would like to officially have Jim join us. So is there a motion that we accept him as a member of the Petoskey Seventh-day Adventist Church? Is there a second? All in favor, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Come up here, Jim. We have a couple gifts for him here. A welcome, your church family album. If when we go to eat here or just have a little refreshment. Maybe you can, there's a space in the first few pages to write a little message of encouragement to him. So that's for you here. And then we do have this five-book series, the Conflict Series. It's basically a commentary, an inspired commentary on the whole Bible, from Genesis to Revelation. And I love it. It begins with the first three words, God is love, and the very last book, the very last three words is God is love. So may the Lord continue to guide you in your daily, well, you can take that, your daily walk with him, your relationship, that's what counts. You're not just joining a church or joining a set of truths, it's joining Jesus. It's Jesus all together with the whole package. And your certificate, your baptismal certificate there. And I like to finish with the role, when the role is called up yonder, I'll be there. We all want to be there, don't we? Amen. Amen. So let's stand up together and we can sing. Thank you. It is 2:16. 2:16. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. That's going to be an amazing thing.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning break eternal bright and fair, when the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the willow roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the willow roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the willow roll is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, yonder I'll be there. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. All together. When the roll is called up yonder, Father in heaven, we cannot wait for that day. We know it's coming soon. And thank you for Jim's decision and how you drew him to yourself. And we know all heaven is rejoicing now. And all heaven rejoice when we choose you every day and yield fully to you. So we just thank you, Jesus. You're the one to be honored and praised. And for your sake and for your honor and glory, Lord, we do all of this and we surrender our lives to you. We thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you. We'll see each other. For those who can have refreshments.